So today, we will be covering a scenario that will allow you to enrich your list of domains with additional customer information. In our example, you have received a list of domains from your sales team, and you want to run a quick automation to retrieve further information, such as the name, the number of employees, and in our particular case, whether it's a startup or a bigger company. Lastly, we want to get a short description. So let's go to our scenario builder. As a first step, we will search for our Google Sheets module. We'll retrieve the Search for Rows module, which allows you to search all columns and rows in your Google Sheet. So let's jump into configuring the spreadsheet. I know my company list is in Google Drive, so I'll leave this option here. Let me just look for it in the list of my spreadsheets. Now, I know that I only have one sheet in that file, so I'll go ahead and select that one. I know my Google Sheet contains headers, so I will leave that option on. I can do the same for the column range, and since I want to return all values, I will leave the filters empty. It seems that we are all set to test out the module, as we don't need any other fields for this example. Let's now run the module to see if we are getting our values back. Great! We can see that we are getting the companies that we wanted. Let's now create an OpenAI module. Let's look for OpenAI and then select the option to create a completion, which is the one that allows me to communicate and write prompts. If you are stuck on how to set up an OpenAI module, just head back to our earlier videos. This time, I choose to create a chat completion as I would like to give it a bit of system context. Before jumping into what system context is, let's first choose a model. In this case, I'll use ChatGPT Omni. And I add a message. You can notice that there are suddenly multiple roles you can choose from. Up to now, we have been using the role of user, which is automatically selected if you choose Create a Prompt Completion instead of Create a Chat Completion. So, if you select the role of a user, the result will be exactly the same as when you write to a ChatGPT or any other chatbot. In contrast, a system user allows you to specify an additional context that underpins all of your prompt. Imagine you could tell your chatbot the context of your entire conversation, and then it would automatically know that any question that follows needs to be responded still within this context. So you can see that a system prompt can be particularly useful for when you send various user messages. Let's add the system context, and I copy-paste the one I prepared. I go on to add my user message. In this message, you can see that I'm specifying that I want help to complete some information on the provided companies and determine whether companies are startups or not. I go on to specify I want my output to be in a JSON format. I want for any domain to return a name, number of employees, which are sorted in 5 different categories. And I want to also tell it shouldn't return anything if it's not sure, which is sometimes important because I want to be in control of what comes out. I will now give it an example of the kind of output that I'm looking for, including the ideal data structure. And then I just put the list of company domains and specify number of tokens. The last thing we need to do is to head up to advanced settings. I scroll down to a field called Response Format. Here, I need to change it to a JSON format instead of the text option to ensure that I don't receive a simple text response. Whenever you want your prompt to return a JSON format, you need to specify this field as well as be explicit in your prompt. And that's it. I can test my module now. I'll choose one of the examples from my list, maybe apple.com. I can see my scenario running. Let's now check the result of our test. All seems to be working just as I wanted, so let's get to the next part. Now it's time to parse the prompt we received from our OpenAI modules so we can return that data to our Google Sheet and save it there. For parsing JSON, I will look for the right module and I select Parse JSON. I can see that I'm asked to create a data structure. For a data structure, I'll just add a new one in my case and I'll name it Companies. I can use generation to make my life much easier since I can just paste in the sample data from our JSON prompt in OpenAI and click on Generate Data Structure. I can see that it pre-populated company, number of employees and startup, and the description of the company in my data structure. Then it's time to add a JSON string, which is the response OpenAI gave me back in the previous module. So I just map the responses directly in my scenario. And that's it for this module. The last step now is to connect again our Google Sheet with the companies. This is because we've now taken the domains our initial Google Sheet, fed them into our OpenAI connection, and we've got back a list of additional information that we want to put back in that original Google Sheet. So let's look for the familiar module that updates our Google Sheet. So I get my Update a Row, which is a module that takes a row of our company list, a company domain, finds the output for that domain, and inserts it back to the appropriate column. Setting my module as usual, I get to the columns where I can pass the data to update my Google Sheet. I locate my companies list. Select the sheet. And map the row number from our first module. Great, all ready to map our values. I don't want to put anything in my first column because I already have values there. Going back to my Google Sheet, I can see that I want company names in column B, number of employees in column C, whether it's a startup in column D, and some short description in column E. So that's what I map in my scenario. And that's it. I click on OK, and let's save and run the entire scenario. Great. Everything is working smoothly. I can see that my Google Sheet reflects the changes, which is exactly what we wanted to achieve with our scenario today. Great. So to sum up, we have learned to use OpenAI to enrich and autocomplete our data. We managed to get from a simple domain to a comprehensive list of companies. Along the way, we also learned about system user and parsing JSON. Well, that's it for today, and I hope to see you in our next video.